My sponsor, Rock Bottom, is currently running a special deal. Head on over to rockbottomcoins.com and use code ZERK at checkout for a 30% off your order. The whole thing wobbing. What's going on, guys? It's Xerxy coming at you today with another YouTube video. Today we have the new Spotlight Players in the Game. And of course, tomorrow, guys, if you don't already know, it's the Madden 20 beta. Now, if you guys don't already know, if you don't follow EA Madden NFL or EA Sports Mode over on Twitter, currently that's probably the best way to go ahead and get yourself some beta codes. If you don't happen to have one, unfortunately, guys, I do not have any more beta codes. Any codes that I had, I gave away. So, unfortunately, I cannot give you guys any more. If I had more beta codes, I promise you, I would give them away to you guys. Unfortunately, I only got a couple because Visionary went to EA Play and actually got a handful of codes to give away. So, unfortunately, I don't have any more, but follow EA Madden NFL and EA Sports Mud on Twitter, and hopefully they'll lead you in the right direction. Please, please, please. There's been scams going around on Twitter. People are trying to sell beta codes, because they're not really selling them. They're just scamming people for beta codes. Do not buy a beta code. I promise you, it's probably not even worth it. It's literally, it starts tomorrow, I want to say noon Eastern time, I think, and then I think it goes for 2 days until like Sunday or maybe Monday morning, I think. So the beta's really not worth it if you're going to be spending money on it. I would not say so. It's just head-to-head. There's no ultimate team. There's no QB1 franchise mode. There might be franchise. I don't know if there's like the regular franchise or not. I know there's head-to-head, and you can use four teams. It's the Rams, Saints, Patriots, and I'm blanking on the fourth one for some reason, but I know it's another really... Oh, the Chiefs. Of course, it's the Chiefs. So that being said, though, let's go ahead and get into some packs. Madden 20 beta starts tomorrow. Unfortunately, you will not see any videos from YouTubers because you can't post about the beta. It's like Fight Club. You can play it, but you can't talk about it. And make sure, please, if you actually have a beta code and you're going to be playing the beta, please use the forums so we can make this game good. You can find the forums pretty easily as well if you go to EA Madden online or in general if you just go over to Twitter. I'll probably even tweet out the beta or the forum tomorrow for you guys. So please, if you play the game, use the forums, make this game good. That's the point of the beta, is to literally make this game the best that it possibly can before it even drops. So I gotta say, I'm really excited to play the beta. I hope it's gonna be really, really good. I think it will be pretty solid, hopefully. I'm gonna try not to be like too... How do I put it? Like, too, like, overhype about the game. Like, oh, this is a brand new game. This game is going to be awesome. Nah, I'm going to try to keep it real. And I don't even know if I'm allowed to, like, tweet out my opinions about it. I'll use the forums, of course. So maybe if you can see other people's posts on the forums, if you guys are on the forums, I'll be posting over there as well. But that being said, though, we do have the new Spotlight players currently in the game. And they actually, I believe, updated the sets as well. So we are going to go ahead and do the 99 overall Future Stars set right now. And we're going to get whoever the 99 overall players are. I believe it's Kerryon Johnson. And I honestly do not remember who the other one is. Let's find out, though. I don't know if they're going to have all four cards now. And it looks like they actually are going to have all four. So we're going to start off with Kerryon Johnson right here. Let's go ahead and see what his stats look like. He has 94 speed, 94 excel. So he's a little bit on the slower side. He's got 90 agility as well. So, okay. But he has 99 carrying, 78 catching, 94 elusiveness with a 99 trucking and a 95 break tackle. So he definitely seems like a trucking back, which... Honestly, I didn't even know Kerryon Johnson was kind of like a trucking back. He does have 86 strength. What is his, like, a stiff arm? 99 stiff arm, 90 spin, and a 98 juke. I really wish it was the other way around because spin moves kind of the meta this year. Let's take a look at his route running and his catching. He's got 75 catch in traffic, 75 short route running, 71 spec catch. I mean, it's definitely a pretty solid card. The other 99 overall card for today is going to be, it's not Baker Mayfield, I'll tell you that. Tremaine Edmund. What is his speed? 93 speed. Okay, I'll take that. He is 6'5" with 93 speed, 93 acceleration. He only has an 80 strength, but he's got 99 tackling, 99 hit power, and 99 block shed. That's freaking good. This is a good card. 95 play rank as well with an 89 zone coverage, and he's got, what's his agility? 93, that's pretty good. Catching's only a 60. Jumping's an 89. So not as good jumping, but he's 6'5" with 99 block shed and 99 hit power. That is crazy, crazy good. 91 finesse move and 81 power move? What the heck? This could literally be a pass rusher with 91 finesse move and 99 block shed. If you put the red chems on and they get his finesse move up, get him up to like, and you have John Madden, get him up to like 95, 96 finesse move, that would be crazy to pair with 99 block shed, 99 hit power. You could literally send him on any sort of blitz up the middle, and he's probably going to end up getting to the quarterback. That is a really, really good card. I really like that Tremaine Edmonds card. Kerryon Johnson, I'm not the biggest fan. But Tremaine Edmonds, that is one heck of a card. I'm not really sure to go with, so I'm not going to pick one right now. Probably just going to pick whichever one is going for the most and then sell them. But let's go and check out the other spotlight cards we have today as well. That Tremaine Edmonds card is really, really freaking good. Especially if you're looking for like a user card, that might just be like the new Anthony Barr. Because Anthony Barr, of course, super tall, and a lot of people love that card as well. So let's see if these new cards are going to be up. And I imagine it's going to be a lot of 99. So we have Rodney Hudson, who is actually a 98 overall. He has 95 strength, 98 awareness, 97 pass blocking, 98 pass block power, 96 pass block finesse, 95 run block, 95 run block power, and a 95 run block finesse. So a lot of 95s in this card. He's got a 72 agility, 66 speed, and 84 acceleration. So could be a little bit quicker. I mean, for a 98 overall card, it looks pretty solid, but I feel like there's a lot better 98 overall centers you could possibly go with. Tremaine Edmonds only going for 420K. Seems pretty cheap for such a good, good card. And I have a feeling I'm probably going to have to hop on over to my head to show you guys the other cards, because it seems like every time they drop these, everyone's doing the 99 overall sets, and no one really cares to the 97 or the 98s, which you can't actually pull these guys in packs. So if you happen to get that lucky, you might make a little bit of coins to pull Tremaine Edmonds, or maybe even Kerryon Johnson. And of course, Jonnu Smith. I feel like I'm probably going to have to hop on over to my head to show you guys this, and I'll hop on over now. So here are the other cards, and the first one is going to be 97 overall Will Hernandez, of course, the offensive guard, the rookie for the New York Giants this year. He has 71 speed and 86 Excel, so not too bad when it comes to speed, but he's got 99 strength. That's really, really good. 96 run block, 94 pass block, 98 run block power, and he's also got a 92 run block finesse with a 94 pass block power and a 91 pass block finesse. Now, he does have 99 impact block, but he only has a 91 lead block. So if you're going to be running behind him, maybe not the best move. But in general, I think the card looks pretty solid. I think it's a little bit weird that he has such low lead block, but yet he has 96 run block with 99 strength. So I think you'll probably be okay, honestly. This is actually a pretty solid guard if you're like a Giants fan. Now we also have Trey Waynes, who of course is going to be super, super fast. He's got 99 speed with a 98 acceleration. He is 6 feet tall with 93 agility, 95 man, 91 zone, and a 94 press. He also has 93 jumping, 95 awareness, 95 play rec to pair with 82 catching, 64 block shed. So really not that good. He's also got a 58 tackling and a crappy, crappy 43 hit power. That's bad. That is really bad. So that's Trey Waynes, Will Hernandez, and we also have Zach Brown, which honestly, he's an outside linebacker. When I saw this card, Muttley tweeted it out, I had no idea as to who this was. Zach Brown, 94 speed with 93 acceleration, 95 block shed. He also has a 94 hit power, 98 pursuit, and a 99 tackling. Now here's the thing. He's got no pass rush and absolutely, absolutely no coverage. That's trash. That is trash. So unless you're using this card either at an outside linebacker or you're going to move into inside linebacker, very weird. Definitely a very, very weird card. I mean, he's got good speed and 94 speed, 93 acceleration. He's got good agility as well for a user card with a 94 agility, 92 jumping, 95 block shed, 94 hit power with a 99 tackling and a 98 pursuit. But, dude, he can't cover it all. He's got 79 zone and he can't pass first. He's got 84 finesse move. That's trash. They does have good catching though at 80, so this is definitely just someone you want to get if you're going to user them every single play. Do not leave this guy out there at all, because he's not going to be able to do anything in coverage, and he's not going to be able to pass rush. So unless you're going to move him to inside linebacker, or if you use your outside linebacker, do not get this card. So those are the new cards for today, and of course, Zach Brown finally just hit the auction house as well, as soon as I'm done showing you guys in my mudhead. In my opinion, don't get Zach Brown. Just get Tremaine Edmonds. He's a way better user card, in my opinion, and price-wise, I mean, Zach Brown's 399K right now, and Tremaine Edmonds is 360K. Obviously, with people actually going ahead and doing the 99 overall set more, Tremaine Edmonds might be very, very close to Zach Brown in terms of price, and this card, in my opinion, is just not that good. I mean, he's got good speed, tackle, block shed, but you really want either a pass rusher or a coverage guy, and he is neither. So, unless you're using him every play, don't get him, and if you want a user card, get Tremaine Edmonds. Again, 99 hit power, 99 block shed, 99 tackling. In my opinion, a much better user card. But I hope you guys did enjoy the video, and if you did, smack the like button, subscribe, and comment. I'll probably have a pack and play video after you guys later today, and of course, Madden 20 beta is coming out tomorrow, so be on the lookout for that. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys next time.